Bienvenidos. Les voy a
Welcome. I am going to talk to you about Solidigm's new UniDesk consoles. The UniDesk IP series is designed to meet the needs of various types of broadcasters, from stations looking to upgrade from their analog consoles, to new ventures that want to incorporate new technologies, such as networking audio. The UX24 is a standalone console. We call it a standalone because all the connections are on the rear panel, making installation simple, and it can be connected just like traditional mixers. The control surface, the analog to digital converters, and the mixing core all make up one unit.
At the rear side, you will find four microphone inputs, connections for both analog and digital stereo inputs, as well as 16 UniDesk multipurpose inputs.
The connections use STP cables with shielded RJ45 connectors. In new installations, this allows for the design of structured wiring, similar to what is used in LANs, using a single type of cable that does not require soldering. The cables will be able to carry analog audio, digital signals, and control data. At the final end, an adapter to the necessary audio connector will be used. In analog consoles, the number of signals or channels that can be mixed is known by counting the number of faders, but for the case of digital mixers, this is not always true. The faders that we see here on the surface do not always indicate the number of channels that the mixer's console manages. The model UX24 has a 24-channel mixing engine, and in its standard version it has 12 mechanical faders, with 2 6 faders modules. But the user can add up to 2 additional 6 faders modules to have 24 hardware faders. The channels that aren't available on hardware can always be controlled using the onboard screen or any external network device. In this case, I can use a tablet, or even a computer with a touch screen. UniDesk inputs are a unique kind of connection made by Solidigm. They let you hook up various signal types with just simple external adapters, so you don't have to mess with IP network gear. If, for example, we need more than 4 microphones, we connect these modules to the UniDesk inputs and that's it. We can have up to 20 microphones.
In setups where signal distribution among multiple studios and devices is required, the solution is to use an audio over IP network. To achieve this, the UX24 can include the Dante AES67 module, offering 16x16 channels at no additional cost. The networked audio integrates seamlessly with UniDesk adapters and the console's standard inputs, providing a unique flexibility of connection. On the other hand, in small radio setups, it's not always necessary to implement an IP audio network when installing a digital console. This approach can be costlier and somewhat more complex. That's why we can use the UX24 as a standalone console where UniDesk adapters connect directly to the console. This setup allows for modular additions of microphone inputs, phone lines, Bluetooth connectivity for mobile phones, computers, and other options.
All functions of the UniDesk external adapters are managed from the console. This adapter allows me to connect a conventional landline and link a mobile phone via Bluetooth. I will show you an example. I am about to receive a call in 3, 2, 1. I am receiving the call through my cell phone. I could answer from the phone, but we have the possibility of answering it from the console, so I simply answer. At this moment, the call is put on hold. The other person is listening to me, but it is not on the air. To talk to him, I simply press Q and it becomes a talkback. I speak through the console's microphone and say, "Please wait a second." And when I want to put the caller on the air, I press the on button. I raise the fader and we are already talking with the other person on the air. Now we are ends the call. Thank you very much to the other side for being there. And this, as I explained, is in the case of a phone call. In the case of a call that is from an application, for example, someone who calls using Zoom, who calls with Skype or any other app, In that cases, I answer from the cell phone and then go to on air from the console. We can also play WhatsApp audios through the console. For example, I received an audio, we are going to play it.
Hola, muy bueno el video. ¿Me podrías explicar en detalle cómo es el tema de operación de las llamadas?
All the videos you want to see, we analyze in our series of tutorials on YouTube. Unidesk lets you host all kinds of conferences. It doesn't matter where the calls are coming from. Like we mentioned earlier, whether it's calls from apps like WhatsApp, LinkedIn, or any new app that pops up in the future. Thanks to this Unidesk feature, it doesn't matter what new app or tech comes along because, fortunately, it doesn't change how we do things on our mixer. So, thanks!
UX24 features two independent streaming outputs that can handle different qualities and codecs. They are used to connect to a transmitting station, other studios, or to upload audio to a public streaming server. Additionally, the console can receive audio from portable devices transmitting via RTP, from streaming servers, or directly download a public stream.
Now, let's dive into the most entertaining part for radio operators: audio processing and sound effects. Unidesk features processors in each of its inputs. Depending on the type of input, we have different processors available. For example, in each microphone input we have a 4-band parametric EQ, with low-pass and high-pass filters. Here we have the equalizer, there we are going to listen to the effect. Then we have compression, noise gate and de-esser. The de-esser, you may be wondering what is it? Well, de-esser is to soften the sibilance, so listen when we activate it. Look how it works. It's amazing. The sound effects like echo, vocoder, reverb, we generate them with a computer that is connected via USB to the mixer console using VST plugins, achieving special effects that will make your station stand out. The plugin receives audio from the console via USB and returns it with the effect.
Ahí lo tenemos. Wow. Efecto eco.
For this demo, I have also set up a vocoder. So let's listen.
Ahora el efecto suena como más punk. Estamos fusionando micrófono con el vocoder.
Now we're talking straight up like Daft Punk.
Para continuar con la explicación.
Let's continue with the explanation. What you heard is exactly what we recorded. As I mentioned earlier, there were no tricks involved.
Vamos a poner todo junto. ¿Se escuchó?
There is no trick. We can do this thanks to the USB technology implemented by Unidesk that allows us to send and receive the audio in real time.
The process settings, input channel assignments, and individual channel configurations are saved within scenes. Users have the ability to create up to 12 customized scenes, facilitating rapid changes to various channel layouts and other settings. Within the scene screen, users can also switch between user profiles, offering three levels of access. The highest level requires a password for full control, while the most limited level is restricted to basic functions.
All console functions can be remotely configured and controlled from a computer or tablet using a web browser. In this case, we have a web browser. And it is a web page where we see the controls of the operative channels. These web pages are generated by the console. And the remote operation panel can manage all 24 channels. However, if the user prefers to work with fewer channels, they can display as few as needed. If I had, for example, a new studio away from the main studio, I can have web pages and operate it without the need to install a second mixer. All these features are very convenient and advanced installations that implement audio over network.
The Dante option allows for transmitting and receiving up to 16 channels. Let's consider an auditorium separated from the main studio. In the auditorium, there are 8 microphones, headphones for monitoring, and a computer with a touch screen. The computer doesn't have audio cards, but can play and record using a Dante virtual sound card. Through the web interface, it's possible to go on the air without the intervention of an operator at the physical console. The remote operator can control the 8 microphones, the computer channels, apply processes, and monitoring. The 24 channels of UX24 are displayed on the screen. Additionally, if there are guest musicians, a multi-track software on the computer can be used to record the microphones on separate channels using Dante while broadcasting live.
So far, we've covered a summary of the most significant features of the UniDesk series. There are still more topics we could discuss, like firmware updates, GPIO signal support, or UniDesk adapter models that we haven't touched upon. However, I invite you to stay updated by following the news and watching educational videos that delve into each of UniDesk's features.
Mi nombre es Celeste Doulier. Los despido y muchas gracias por su tiempo. Chao.